Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today we've got a box full of Batman, so let's get into it. So quite a few Batman the Animated Series figures to look at today. So over the last month or so I've been scouring eBay for these. What's great is some of the figures come up really often, and if you're patient you can pick some of them up cheaply. There's examples here where I've been the only bidder and I've been able to pick up loose figures for their starting bid, which is great. What's good about the line is you can get some figures for around £10 or less, and then some of the rarer figures can be over £100. So for me, for now, I'm picking up some of the easier figures, filling out that Batman shelf, and then in the future I'll probably start to chip off some more expensive ones. So we'll take a look at the ones loose in the bag first, then we'll take a look at the free carded examples. So let's just get those out of the way and we'll get started. So first of all, we've got a Robin in this bag. Now this is the second version of Robin, so this is the one from the New Adventures, which takes place after the animated series. So this toy line covers loads of different Batman cartoons and media, which is awesome. So here he is. As usual, you get loads of articulation and he looks like he's come straight out of the cartoon. Pretty nice figure, that one. And like I've said before, with these figures you get a ton of accessories, which is why I think they're such great value for money. So you get all these different sort of interchangeable hands. You get like the bat claw. You get these shackles as well. And then as always, you get one of these stands. So you simply just push that in there, twist that round, and then you can manipulate this up and down as close it as much as you want, which will allow you to get your figure into loads of different poses. Just to give you an idea, that's how a basic pose would be. In the next pack, we have got Commissioner Gordon from the animated series, so let's get him out. Another brilliant figure who literally looks like he's straight off the screen. Looks like this guy stands up quite well with without the stand. A lot of the figures will struggle to stand up without the stand, especially the skinnier ones who are more top heavy. So there's the base, and then we'll take a look at all the accessories he comes with. He comes with loads. So let's have a look. Get this sort of, I forgot what you call this, like megaphone that he shouts through, obviously, because he's a policeman. You get this little revolver, which is quite decently detailed. As detailed as it needs to be to look like it's from a cartoon. And then you get four spare hands. So we'll just put the base together. Then I imagine he will stand up in there quite nicely. And what I'll do is at the end, I'll line all the figures up in some poses. Next of all, we have got Catwoman. So I have a Catwoman already, but that version is different because that's based on the normal animated series, whereas this is a New Adventures one. So if you don't know what the New Adventures is, basically some of the last seasons of Batman the Animated Series, they completely changed the appearance of it. So I'll put an image up on screen now just to show you a comparison. They kept pretty much the same voice actors, but decided to just do a visual change to make the show a bit more darker. But personally, I prefer the original look of the show rather than when they changed it. Don't change what isn't broken, in my opinion. So let's get this out. So, we'll look at the figure first. As usual, got all the articulation you would need. And accessory-wise, you get the whip. You get the little cat as well, which I imagine you can put on the shoulders like the other figure could. The stand with your images of the character. Several interchangeable hands. And then the display base, which we will just quickly assemble. Slide that in there. Right, so we'll get her into a pose in a bit and I will show you them all at the end. Last of all, we got the main man himself, Batman. in his New Adventures appearance. Him out. So he actually comes with two capes, which is pretty cool. We'll take a look at the differences because I'm not too sure. Looks like one of them's just slightly more curved, I guess, than the other. Not much difference between them, to be fair. So he's really nice. Really animated face there, which is good. All the articulation again. And then we'll look at his accessories. Got like the back claw there. You actually remove that. Looks like, yeah, you can remove that if you want, like it's fired away. And what else have we got? Literally loads and loads of different hands. Batarang. Batman's hand literally firing the Batarang. Get the stand into place. So I actually, it would have been a few weeks ago now, perhaps nearly a month ago now, I finished all the animated series and the New Adventures and I really enjoyed it, so I would recommend watching them if you haven't. And Batman Beyond, which is another series, I'm definitely going to check that out next, so I'll be picking up the Blu-ray set for that soon. Right, so we move on to the last three items of the day. So obviously carded examples here. These two here, they're actually brand new, but they're sort of damaged cards. But I'll take the figures off anyway, so that's not a problem. Then this one's been resealed, but I'll be cracking that one open. So let's take a look. I've gone ahead and opened up the Talia figure, so another really good one. What's good is in the actual boxes, you get like an inlay tray, which holds the accessories. So I'm just going to leave them in there for now. Just some hands. You actually get the pistol, so I've kept that out. But yeah, she's a really nice figure. I'll just give that a turn around. So that's really cool. Right, so here we have the last two figures of the day. So we have Firefly and we have the anti-fire suit Batman. So these two figures complement each other very well. So they're actually from the same episode. Essentially, Firefly is like a pyromaniac. And basically, Batman has to make a fireproof suit, hence the name anti-fire Batman. So these are some really nice figures. Really digging the Batman in particular. Sort of similar to the usual Batman design, but you can't even see his face. He's fully protected. Comes with the blaster as well. It's proper cool. And then Firefly. This is a really detailed figure. They've even gone to the effort to give you sort of minor details on the belt. The gun I've actually holstered, which is awesome. Really nice head sculpt. And then he has the actual detailed wings as well. So really impressed with both of these ones. So yeah, here's all the figures in their entirety, so really happy with these. Like I said before, just enjoy collecting this line. I love how refreshing the prices are compared to Star Wars, just because of how cheap some of these are, and all the accessories and detail you get for your money as well. So gone ahead and put them into loads of different poses. Really looking forward to getting these on the shelf with my others. So as always guys, thank you for watching. Make sure to like, comment and subscribe, and I will catch you on the next one. Thank you.